In the previous video, I have talked about the script debugger and setting up a breakpoint. You could find the link for that video in the description below. In this video, I'm going to talk about the conditional breakpoint. While having the ability to set breakpoints is useful, there may be scenarios like executing a for loop or iterating over a list of items where the execution would have to be paused many times if breakpoint is inside the loop. So that is where you can use the conditional breakpoint. If you use that, instead of pausing the execution on the same breakpoint multiple times, you could set a conditional breakpoint which would pause the execution only if the condition specified by you evaluates to true. Now let's take a look at an example using a script include. This is a script include I have created for this demo. You can see that there is a breakpoint already set here. And this is the method that I have added in the script include, which would return me an array of values. In this case, these are the prices. You can see that the script include name is inventory prices. Now let's go to the business rule on inventory update that I have created in the previous demo. You can see that I made a few changes to the script. I'm calling the new script include over here and the method getLatest, which would return me an array of values from 101 to 105. And I'm iterating over those values here. Now let's put a breakpoint over here and update the inventory table, which would trigger this business rule. And let's open our debugger before that. You can see that there are two breakpoints, one in the script include inventory prices on line number 7 and the other one on business rule at line number 9. Now let's go back to the inventory table and update the category from computers to computer. You can see that we got the debugging notification and the first breakpoint is hit. Once we resume the execution, we go to line number 9 in the business rule. Now observe what happens over here. You can see that the value of I keeps on changing because we are iterating over the items from the getLatest method. So you can see that it executed 5 times and the execution has been paused 5 times at line number 9. The problem that we face right now is if I want to pause the execution only when latest price value is 103, in that case I would have to resume the execution twice. You can overcome that problem using a conditional breakpoint. To add a conditional breakpoint, you can right click on any breakpoint and press add condition. In the text box that is presented to you, you can write any boolean condition. In my case, I want the latest price value to be 103. Once you are done with the condition, you can press enter. You can see that the breakpoint color has changed. And if you hover over it, you can see the value of the condition that you entered. Now let's go back to the inventory table and update a row. We got the debugging notification and the first breakpoint that is hit is the script include inventory prices. And if I resume the execution, it goes to the second breakpoint, which is line number 9 in the business rule. You can see that the I value is 2.0 instead of 0.0. It means that the for loop is already executed twice. And if I press resume again, it will stop the execution because this is a conditional breakpoint. We won't reach the value of I 3.0. So that is how a conditional breakpoint works. Apart from adding a condition to a breakpoint, you can also add a new conditional breakpoint by right clicking on the gutter and pressing add conditional breakpoint. You can press anywhere on the screen to save it. And you can also remove a condition or edit a condition. And if we remove it, it'll become a normal breakpoint. And you can also click on the breakpoint or a conditional breakpoint to remove them. You can also perform the same operations in the script editor where you write the script. if we go back to the debugger, you can see that the same conditional breakpoint is reflected over here as well. And that's about the conditional breakpoint. In the next video, we'll look at the debugger actions. Meanwhile, if you have any queries, please reach out to community.servicenow.com.